Good morning to all. Welcome to e-classes. Myself, Ramatanki Rajavva, lecturer in Electrical and Electronics Engineering, GMR Polytechnic, Outnoor, Adilabad district. I am going to teach you power system 3, switchgear and protection. On completion of this class, you would able to understand variety type lighting arrestor, lead oxide lighting arrestor, neutral earthing or grounding, Peterson coil, arcing grounds, methods of neutral grounding. These are topics are discussed in this class. So first one, variety type lighting arrestor. This is most common and is mostly used for the protection against very high dangerous voltage. Variety type lighting arrestor is the most common and is mostly used for the protection against very high dangerous voltages. Ferrite is a dense inorganic compound which possesses the special property that its resistance varies from high values at low voltage to low values at high voltages. The ferrite type lighting arrestor property special, that is that its resistance varies from high values at low voltage to low values at high voltages. It consists of discs of 15 centimeters diameter and 19 mm thickness. 15 centimeter diameter and 19 mm thickness. Both the sides are metal spread so as to give electrical contact between consequent discs. These discs are assembled inside the glazed porcelain container. These discs are assembled inside the glazed porcelain container. When lighting takes place, voltage becomes high and the breakdown of the gap occurs. The resistance falls to a very low value and wave is discharged to earth. Resistance falls to very low value and wave is discharged to earth. After the surge has passed, the ferrite again comes back to its original. Ferrite again comes back to its original property. There being no chemical change occurring permanently. The cross section of ferrite distribution arrestor unit is the ferrite arrestor discharge several thousand amperes without the slightest tendency to flash over on the edges. Most important of all the advantages of this type of arrestor is that there is absolutely no time lock in its performance. No time log in its performance. See the therapy type lighting arrestor diagram. So first one, compression spring and metal top fitting, sealing gasket, wet to process, porcelain gap spacer, therapy resistor which shunts and shields gap unit, electrodes two sides and shunt gap, therapy type shunt gap containers two sides and name plate, compression spring, drain valve, sealing gasket, metal bottom fitting, cement. These are parts of the therapy type lighting arrestor. So cm diameter and 19 mm thickness, both sides are metal spread. Next one, lead acid lighting arrestors. It works on the principle that certain dry chemicals change very rapidly from good conductors to almost perfect insulators when heat is applied. For example, lead peroxide, which has specific resistance of 1 ohm per inch cube at ordinary temperature, is converted to red lead at about 150 degrees Celsius. Its specific resistance being then of the order of 24 million ohms per inch cube. For example, lead peroxide, which has a specific resistance of 1 ohm per inch cube at ordinary temperature, is converted to red lead at about 150 degrees Celsius, its specific resistance being then one of the order of 24 million ohms per inch cube. The lead acid arrestor, the actual arrestor consists of number of cells. Each cell consists of two iron electrodes coated with varnish on one side. Each cell consists of two iron electrodes coated with varnish on one side. The electrodes are separated by an annular ring. The space so formed between the electrode is filled with lead peroxide power. Each cell can be used for voltages in the range of 250 to 300 volts. When an over voltage occurs on the line, the varnish film breaks down at one or more points in every cell and discharge passes through the lead peroxide, which is converted to red lead due to heating, As soon as this happens, the discharge will cause the power current cannot flow to the ground. The power current cannot flow to the ground because of the high resistivity of the red lead. Gradually, However, the whole of the lead peroxide will be converted into red lead, but the dimensions of the cell are so chosen that it takes a number of years before it becomes useless. For further service becomes useless for further service. See the diagram, lead oxide arrester. So to our electrodes, iron plates, so only one side varnish the film powder and porcelain annular rods and totally lead peroxide powder filling. Advantages of lead oxide arrester. It does not require daily charging and can be used in remote locations where daily supervision is not required. It does not require daily charging and can be used in remote locations where daily supervision is not required. And disadvantages. It is not so sensitive to lower types of transients because the action of this lighting arrester depends upon the breaking of the varnish film. So next one is grounding. So necessity of neutral grounding or earthing. All the power system of today operate with grounded neutrals. Neutral grounding offers several advantages. The neutral point of generator, transformer, rotating machines, etc. is connected to earth either directly or through a impedance. Connected to earth either directly or through a impedance. The neutral earthing is one of the most important feature of the system design. The neutral earthing is one of the most important feature of the system design. The neutral grounding is important in power system practice because the earth fault protection is based on the method of neutral earthing. So second one, the system voltage during earth fault depends on neutral earthing. Third one, neutral earthing has associated switch gear. Fourth one, neutral earthing is provided basically for the purpose of protection against arcing grounds, unbalanced voltage with respect to earth, protection from lighting, and for improvement of the system. So because of necessity of neutral grounding or earthing, the power system network. So grounding, the process of connecting the metallic frame of electrical equipment or some electrical part of the system to earth is called grounding or earthing. To the process of connecting the metallic frame of electrical equipment or some electrical part of the system to earth is called grounding or earthing. So metallic frame means non-current carrying part to earth or soil. Grounding or earthing may be classified two types. equipment grounding, system grounding. Equipment grounding, system grounding. So next one, equipment grounding. The process of connecting non-current carrying metal parts of the electrical equipment to earth. The process of connecting non-current carrying metal parts of the electrical equipment to earth. So second one, system grounding. The process of connecting some electrical part of the power system to earth, for example soil, is called system grounding. The process of connecting some electrical part of the power system to earth is called system grounding. And next one, neutral grounding. Connecting neutral point to earth either directly or some circuit element, for example resistance, reactance, Peterson coil, is called neutral grounding. Neutral grounding provides a protection to equipment during earth fault. The current path is completed neutral. Advantages of neutral grounding. Advantages of neutral grounding. Voltage of the healthy phases do not exceed line to ground voltage. For example, they remain nearly constant. The high voltages due to arcing grounds are eliminated. Life of insulation is long. Life of insulation is long. The over voltages is reduced. It provides greater safety to personal and equipment. It provides improved service reliability. Operating and maintenance expenditure are reduced. And trouble due to arcing grounds is present. The over voltage due to induced operating and maintenance expenditure are reduced. And disadvantages of neutral underground neutral system. Under a single line to ground fault, the voltage to earth of healthy phases becomes full line value. This may result in insulation breakdown and may even lead to heavy phase to phase fault condition. The voltage due to lighting surges do not find path to earth. Due to the above disadvantages, underground system are not commonly used. So next one, methods of neutral grounding. These are five types. Solid grounding, resistance grounding, arc suppression or Peterson coil grounding, reactance grounding, voltage transformer grounding, earthing transformers or zigzag transformer. The first three are important methods of neutral grounding. What are they? So solid grounding, resistance grounding, arc suppression, Peterson coil grounding. Three are most important methods of न्यूट्रल ग्राउंडिंग। सो फर्स्ट वन सॉलिड आर इफेक्टिव ग्राउंडिंग, सॉलिड आर इफेक्टिव ग्राउंडिंग। सो थ्री फेजेस आर वाई बी, सो थ्री फेजेस आर कनेक्टेड इन रिएक्टेंट्स। सो ए न्यूट्रल इज कनेक्टेड टू अर्थ, IF, IR, IY. So three phases flow the currents, three currents. Solid grounding system, the neutral is directly connected to earth, directly connected to earth or soil is called solid grounding or effective grounding. Solid grounding or effective grounding, the neutral is directly, neutral point to three phase system is directly connected to earth, connected to earth through a wire of negligible resistance and reactance is neglected. When an earth fault occurs between earth and any one phase, the voltage to earth of the fault phase becomes zero, but the healthy phases remains at normal phase values. When an earth fault occurs between earth and any one phase, the voltage to earth of the fault phase becomes zero, but the healthy phases remains at normal phase values. Fault current IF completely, fault current IF completely null filled by capacitive current IC. And one more point is here, for a fault on phase B, see the diagram, for a fault on phase B voltage VRE and VYE are still maintained at their values, the capacitive current flows in the healthy phases or ICR and ICY will let their corresponding voltage by 90 degrees. Earth fault current IF is a 90 degrees lagging with respect to phase to neutral voltage of fault phase. The total capacitive current ICF is resultant of ICR and ICY. It will be seen that the fault current IF being in phase opposition to capacitive current ICF completely null filled. The effect of capacitive current ends no arcing ground phenomenon or over voltage condition can occur. So disadvantages of solid grounding: heavy earth fault current result in greater interference to neighboring communication circuits, and second one, heavy fault currents are quite difficult to be handled in the circuit breakers. The solid earthing is used for system having normal circuit impedance is sufficiently high to prevent excessively high current values being reached. These are two disadvantages of solid grounding. So next one, resistance grounding. When the neutral point of three-phase system, for example, generator, transformers, is connected to earth through resistor, it is called resistance grounding. When the neutral point of three-phase system is connected to earth through resistor, it is called resistance grounding. So three phases are YB. So neutral is connected to resistance to earth. It is called as resistance grounding. And capacitive resistance, capacitive inductance are connected in parallel. And resistance grounding, it is becomes necessary to limit the earth fault current. This type of earthing is used in this method of neutral ground earthing resistor is inserted between the neutral and earth to limit the current to safer value. So because of connected to resistance between the neutral and earth. And a three-phase power system with neutral grounded to resistance, for a fault on phase B, the line to earth voltage of healthy phase VR and VY will be slightly more than the normal values. The capacitive currents ICR and ICY led VRE and VYE respectively by 90 degrees. The total capacitive current ICF is the resultant of ICR and ICY. Advantages of resistance grounding. By adjusting the value of R, the resistance, the arcing grounds can be minimized. It improves the stability, less interference, minimize the hazards, and reduce the risk of arcing grounds. Ground fault current is lower than in solid grounding system. Disadvantages. This system is costlier than the solid grounding system. So by adjusting the value of R, the arcing grounds can be minimized. It improves the stability, less interference, minimize the hazards. So and next one is Peterson coil or arc suppression coil grounding or resonant grounding. It is also called as Peterson coil grounding or ground fault neutralizer. In the arc suppression coil method of earthing, the arcing grounds danger has been eliminated and the system is approximated to the isolated neutral system in which one or two healthy phases continue to supply power and complete shutdown is avoided. Completely shutdown is avoided. It operates on the principle that if an inductance of appropriated value is connected in parallel with the capacitance, the fault current can be reduced considerably or even it can be neutralized. An arc suppression coil is an iron core reactor connected between the neutral of the power system and earth. See the diagram. The three-phase system with neutral grounded through an arc suppression coil. For a fault on phase B, voltage to earth of healthy phases VRE and VYE are root 3 times the normal values. The capacitive currents ICR and ICY led their corresponding voltage by 90 degrees. The total capacitive current ICF is resultant of ICR and ICY. ICR and ICY. Arc suppression coil current ISF 90 degrees lagging current with respect to phase to neutral voltage of fault to phase and is in direct opposition to ICF by a proper choose of inductance of the coil. ISF can be made equal to ICF. Hence, no arcing ground phenomenon can occur. If inductance L of appropriated value is connected to parallel with the capacitance of the system, the fault current IF flowing through L will be in phase opposition to the capacitive current IC of the system. If L is so adjusted that IL is equal to IC, then resultant current in the fault will be zero. This condition is known as resonant grounding. When the value of L of arc suppression coils such that the fault current IF exactly balances the capacitive current IC, it is called resonant grounding. An arc suppression coil, also called Peterson coil, is an iron core coil connected between the neutral and earth. The reactor is provided with tappings to change the inductance of the coil. By adjusting the tappings and the coil can be tuned with the capacitance of the system. Resonant grounding can be achieved. Suppose line to ground fault occurs in the line B at point F. The fault current IF and capacitive currents IR and IY will flow as shown in figure. Note that IF flows through the Peterson coil or arc suppression coil to neutral and back through the fault. The total capacitive current IC is the phasor sum of IR and IY. the voltage of the fault phase is applied across the arc suppression coil. Therefore, fault current IF lags the fault phase voltage by 90 degrees. The current IF is in phase opposition to capacitive current IC by adjusting the tappings on the Peterson coil. The resultant current in the fault can be reduced if inductance of the coils, so adjusted that IL is equal to IC, then resultant current in the fault will be zero. So value of L for resonant grounding. For resonant grounding, the system behaves as an ungrounded neutral system. Therefore, full line voltage appears across capacitors CR and CY. So IR is equal, IY is equal root 3 VPH by XC, phase voltage VPH. So XC capacitive impedance, reactance. So IC is equal root 3 IR is equal, in substitute the IR value, root 3 into root 3 VPH by XC. So root 3 cancel, so 3 VPH by XC. Hence XC is the line to ground capacitive reactance. Fault current IF is equal VPH by XL. So XL is the inductive reactance of the arc suppression coil. For resonant grounding, IL is equal IC. VPH by XL is equal VPH, so 3 VPH by XC. So we can take in the XL, so XL is equal XC by 3 or omega L by 1 by 3 omega C. So omega L, so L is equal 1 by 3 omega square C, gives the value of inductance L of the suppression coil for resonant grounding. Advantages. The Peterson coil grounding is the following advantages. The Peterson coil is completely effective in preventing any damage by an arcing ground. The Peterson coil has the advantages of ungrounded neutral system. Disadvantages. The Peterson coil grounding has the following disadvantages. Due to varying operational condition, the capacitance of the network changes from time to time. Therefore, inductance L of Peterson coil requires readjustment. The lines should be transposed. And next one, voltage transformer earthing. In this method of neutral earthing, the primary of single phase voltage transformer is connected between the neutral and earth. A low resistor in series with a relay is connected across the secondary of the voltage transformer. The voltage transformer provides high reactance in the neutral earthing circuit and operates virtually as an ungrounded neutral system. See the diagram. So RYB, so three generator windings, and neutral is connected to voltage transformer earthing, and relay also connected. advantages of arcing grounds are reduced and transient overvoltage are reduced. And in this class there are D-type writing arrestors, there are D-type writing arrestors and earthings and Peterson coil, arc suppression coil, resonant coil, resistance grounding, solid grounding, voltage transformer grounding and earthing of transformers, lead oxide type lighting arresters. So these are discussed in this class. In this class important questions, terity type lighting arrester and types of neutral groundings, solid grounding, resistance grounding, arc suppression grounding, reactance grounding, voltage transformer grounding and earthing of transformer grounding. So these are most important questions. And draw the circuit diagrams and phasor diagrams, practice carefully. And I will explain earthing of transformer. So earthing transformers are used to provide an artificial neutral earthing point on those system where neutral points are not accessible or where generator or transformer windings are delta connected. So earthing of transformers. Earthing transformers are used to provide an artificial neutral earthing point on those system where neutral points are not accessible or where generator or transformer windings are delta connected. These are definition of earthing transformer. And voltage transformer grounding. Voltage transformer grounding is used for generators directly connected to step up power transformer. A system grounded through a voltage transformer operates virtually as an isolated neutral system, but the presence of voltage transformer in the neutral connection provides an indication of fault to earth on the system. A low resistor in series with a relay is connected across the secondary of the voltage transformer. The voltage transformer provide a high reactance in the neutral earthing circuit and operates virtually as an ungrounded neutral system. This is the important voltage transformer thing. Important. And advantages, arcing grounds are reduced, transient over voltage are reduced. And thank you one and all. Thank you very much. I hope understand my class. Okay, thank you. Thank you one and all.